I thought it was very explosive by the offense. Big plays. Started out with some shorter stuff, some screens. They were all over those, and then we started putting it downfield and really good at it. Justin, of course. I mean, it's like being around greatness every day. That's all I can say. Just every day get to watch him. And love to run. I mean, I thought that really got us going, really sparked us. And he can show what he can do. He can run. He can run fast. And Ladd, I mean, tremendous day. Some big time catches down the field by Ladd, and then finishing on the touchdown. I think he's in some rare company now with rookie wide receivers for the Chargers. In the history, 100 yards, 2 touchdowns in a game. I think it's only been done like 4 times. There's been some really, really good receivers. And I just want to say that about our receivers. I mean, we love them. And Josh Palmer, another really good game. Will Disley, doing some great things. Love the way Justin, just like he said he would go back to Jalen Reagor and went to him in a crucial situation. Thought that was outstanding. That's a real leader, I could tell. Sometimes the ball was snapped, what he did with his eyes, and then he was going to rakes. So big play, great catch by him. So many other good things. I thought the offensive line, it was a real battle. In there, J.K. Dobbins, a tremendous job by him. Those were tough yards that he was getting. I thought he really sparked us in the second half. With that, it was an 11-yard run, but that's the hardest 11-yard run I think I've ever seen a guy make. The tackles he was breaking. It was, a lot of guys, a lot of heroes from this game. I want to point out J.K. Scott, who had a tremendous game. Not just a great game. I mean, a tremendous game by him, flipping the field. Numerous times with some big, huge punts. And then the defense, gave up some yards, but made the plays. We had to. I mean, really only gave up 6 points on defense today, which it's almost impossible to do in the NFL. Great play. The holding penalties, that our guys got. I mean, it was a relentless day. I mean, you can just tell you guys were in there in the locker room, right? I mean, you can see the price the guys paid. I mean, there's a price to be paid for these wins, and they really spent themselves. Just look around the locker room and see the guys like J.K. and Morgan Fox, Brad Bozeman, Mr. Slater, Mr. Alt, just guy after guy, you know the price that they paid. I mean, they gave it their all. They left it all out there in the field, and I thought played a pretty. I mean, 4 quarters of really good football, offense, defense, and special teams. Very pleased, very proud. Pull it down, and we'll go search for our next win. Well, it's not an if. I mean, he can get the if out of it. He can most definitely. I mean, he's sure fast enough. He's sure been effective as an outside receiver, as a slot receiver. We've known that. And his ability to find the ball, I mean, it's in contested catches is very special. Saw it again today. Touchdown he had a few weeks ago. Very similar. How did he come down with that? How did Justin put the ball, just right there in the exact perfect spot, 47 yards downfield? I mean, it's great. I mean, and our receivers know it. They know. I mean, they could appear to be covered, but number 10 is going to put the ball in, on a dime, where where they got a chance to make the play. So everybody running, everybody alert, and but yeah, special. That takes nothing away from Vlad. I mean, that's incredible. The catch he made today, I didn't think there was any room for it to, you know, really come down. And but you know, he found it, tracked it, you know, made an unbelievable catch. And then, you know, Sports Center highlight the clip right after that, you know, to go score that touchdown and put the ball in the end zone. It's just, it's good. I mean, it's what we needed. It's what we've been needing. I always think of it like the my dad's got this great analogy of the old olive jar. You know, they get packed in there so tight that you open the lid on it, you could turn it over and nothing comes out. Not even any juices seeping out. But if you can just get one, like Lad's touchdown, and then another, and then another, and then they start popping out and pop, 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 pop. That's what we're going for. I think you know, that's something that we certainly did today. I mean, to, you know, make the play, but then finish with the ball in the end zone. Or, you know, Justin, you know, makes the big 34-yard run, and then you know, we finish with points, or we finish in the end zone. You know, JK makes that, those kind of runs. I mean, it's what it takes. I mean, you got to pry those things out of there. And the olives are the touchdowns. I mean, it's both the same. And get them pried out, and then, you know, certainly does a lot for us. You know?
Coach Scott Matlock, a lot of his stats won't jump off the page, but his impact on the game is undeniable. Today he had a huge kickout block that sprung J.K. Dobbins for a touchdown, huge sack. He also caught a pass to move the chains. How does his game embody the spirit of the team?
Yeah, I mean, you talk about leaving it all out there, right? I mean, catch a pass, touchdown block, get a sack, you know, all in the same game. And what he's doing, getting his job done on special teams. You know, that's why we gave him a game ball in the locker room after the game. I mean, you know, we love him. He's he's a hero to us.
The safety early in the game, was that just a missed snap there?
Or yeah. Yeah.
Just a misfire.
Yeah, a little wide right. And JK, you know, did what he could. But the guy who made the incredible play is Sana Haskins. I mean, man, H2, I mean, he just came hustling over there from the wing position and was able to get that ball out. I mean, it's that kind of, I mean, that's a heroic play. It's a heroic play in the game, you know, two instead of seven. And that's a big difference. He had another great play on the kickoff return. I didn't think we blocked it as well. And he had about five guys that took a shot at him. Finally, the sixth guy, you know, got him down, but you know, still got the ball out to the 34-yard line and hung onto the ball. I mean, he's a football player. Those kind of guys, yeah. I mean, what do they do for the team? It's they embody you know, whatever you want to call it. I mean, the spirit, you know, and yeah, then it gets infectious, you know, where other people wanna. Rise up to that, you know. Want to do the same thing. Guys that are playing with, working through something, you know. We all know what they are, what they're working through, and you know, the price they're paying and being out there and helping our team, and that becomes infectious too. But that's what I would say to answer your question about Scott, or plays that like H2, or the Lad makes, or, you know, JK, or, you know, all the guys. JK Scott. I think I mentioned that, right? Game ball for JK Scott. Incredible game. So just keep, you know, building, better. That's what we're going for.
Coach, with JK
offsetting personal fouls.
Yeah.
Obviously their defensive lineman looked to be kind of grabbing at Justin's ankle, but Bradley came over and delivered a shot. Do you like that from an offensive lineman sort of protecting the quarterback in that situation after the play?
I think it's just something that's instinctual, you know. Those offensive linemen, I mean, you ask them to do so much. I mean, they got a run block. I mean, they're hitting every play. They got a pass block. I mean, you're asking them to pursue the play just in case there's a fumble. down the field. They got to hustle and do that. I mean, we ask so much of them. We don't ask them to, you know, clean the piles and things like that. But, yeah, man, I think it was, I mean, everybody knows Justin got a bad ankle. And, you know, so you got, I mean, I wasn't out there. I just saw what I saw. I don't know how long it was going on. But, you know, that's, I mean, that's going on too long. It should be, an injection, ejection. Yeah, I mean, I guess I don't blame him. I don't encourage that, at all. But you know, I don't blame him either. I mean, that's how they're wired. I mean, offensive linemen, they're protectors. You know, they're healers. They're forces for good.
Coach J.K. Dobbins, he's been a very consistent piece for this offense, running the ball, catching the ball out of the backfield. Is this kind of the player that you envisioned when you guys brought him in during the offseason?
Yeah. J.K. all day. That was his nickname back in his collegiate days. But there was – I've seen it from him before, but I mean, there's a thing that happens. I mean, the kind of competitor he is, a fierce competitor. I mean, it came out in a way that everybody saw it on that 11-yard run that was fierce. Just fierce. I mean, did not want to be denied. Was not gonna go down. Was gonna do everything he could to be a hero and spark our team and lift us up when we needed it in the second half there. And I thought it really did. I mean, it's a shining star example if everything else. And yeah, there's a fierceness there. And he keeps going the way he's going. I mean, if he hasn't already been nominated for Comeback Player of the Year, if he has, then I'll add to it and be singing with the choir. But if I am the first to nominate him, then so be it. I'll nominate him for Comeback Player of the Year.
Coach, you know, was a tough play. How big was the Dobbins touchdown to finish the 15-play, 90-play drive? Because you've had some long drives like that throughout the season that have kind of finished with field goals instead of touchdowns.
What's your question?
The Dobbins touchdown is in second quarter. How big of that was a momentum lift? Going in a half,
yeah, huge. With huge. You know, it just, we get down there in the three and we get a false start. I mean, things we're working hard to, you know, to clean up and you know, not do. And then, you know, so the first and three, it's first and eight. And he got hit behind the line, you know, got hit at the line before the goal line. And you could just see it from the, you know, that point on. He wasn't going to be denied, you know. Was not going to be denied. Let's feed him. And those are all, I mean, tough. I mean, 1.5 yard carry. 1.5 yard carry, 2 yard carry. Then there's some threes and, you know, some fours, and then back to didn't have any 1 yard carries after that. But then, you know, then the 10. Those are that's a, I mean, what was it, 59 yards for 49 for JK? 57 for JK. That's 57 hard-earned, not going to be denied type of yards. But yeah, that's the kind of thing that, you know, lifts the ball, kind of makes you a hero to your team.
Coach, there's a toughness that just comes with wherever you've been and wherever you go. You're a tough player when you play, but it's starting to really show with this Chargers team.
You don't have to keep that to yourself, too. You can kind of spread the word.
But honestly, with Justin's a tough guy, but it just feels like this year there's just something different about him and just this team as a whole. What does it mean as a coach when you pour it onto your team and they embody almost who you are, and then it translates to the football field, like the number one scoring defense in the NFL right now?
Yeah, no, I mean, there's only tough players. I mean, there's no such thing as tough coaches. It's just there isn't. I promise you. There isn't. It's just tough players. I appreciate you saying I was a tough player. I feel good about that, but these guys, Justin Herbert, I mean, I could have done it, I think. I could have played with a high ankle sprain, could have played it, but I wouldn't have been good enough with a high ankle sprain to be out there and help my team. And he's got a high ankle sprain playing a week later and still got a 100 quarterback rating in each of those games. I mean, that's what I'm saying. It's like being around greatness every day. And I'm not nearly as tough as like Khalil Mack. I mean, there's a guy he's working through stuff, but it doesn't, he still plays with this perfection, this grace, it's like Joe DiMaggio, with a heel spur, he just, there's no difference, in the play. They're just, those great players are just, they're tough and they're really good, that you wouldn't even know that would have affected a guy like me. Yeah, I could have played through it, but I wouldn't have been good. Like, I wouldn't have been great like they are, and JK, and again, the guys up front, offense and defense, the line, it's a talent. I truly believe that. Toughness is a talent, and there's no coach that can take any credit for that particular player's talent of being tough. I can't take any credit for the talent that Justin has for throwing the ball, or the Khalil Mack has for rushing the pass. They're great. That's why they'll be in the Hall of Fame someday. And those are those kind of players. So appreciate the question.
There's no
tough coaches. Pardon?
Wasn't a tough coach?
Toughness? Toughness is playing. Players are tough. Tough.
Well, today's tough performance.
That's that talent of being tough as a player. Yeah, I think that's just players. I mean, you can be a strategist. You can be an advice giver. You can be an example setter. But you don't really get a chance to. It's about as closest thing to miss the last bastion of hope, for outside the military too, where physical, mental toughness on display, on a daily basis, the military and football, those are our last bastions of hope for toughness. And maybe I'm overreaching there, but I just, having played, I know what these guys go through, and being around them every day, it's the talent of toughness that they have is it's off the charts. A lesser man couldn't do it, and we're talking lesser, but that's going to be about 99% of the population, what these guys go through. Nothing but respect, put it that way. I didn't shut up.
Will today's performance impact your thought process before the trade deadline, either way?
Joe, that's a Joe Ortiz question. And I know he's got our back, he's got our front, he's got both sides, front, back, and sides. And I know he's always going to be doing whatever he can to help our team.
All right, thanks, Coach.
Thanks a lot.